Hope you are enjoying this video. Till now we have seen a practical demonstration of how solar panel converts solar energy into electricity. Now we will be moving to the engineering and technical aspects of solar panel. I will be showing how to characterize a solar panel and getting its parameters. Let's move on. Sunlight is the most abundant and free energy source available to humans. After years of experiments, scientists developed the photovoltaic cell to convert solar energy into electricity. The solar cell or photovoltaic cell is typically made of silicon, which absorbs photon emitted by solar rays. Solar cells are connected in series or parallel to get the required power rating. Let us see what's happening inside the solar cell. Electrically, a solar cell is similar to the normal PN junction diode. But construction wise, a solar cell consists of a thin, heavily doped N-type layer, which forms the front electrode, and a thick, lightly doped P-type layer, which forms the back electrode. Thus, a depletion layer is formed similar to a PN junction diode. This potential difference forms the driving force to create a unidirectional flow of charge carriers. When the cell is exposed to sunlight, photons penetrate through the N-type region and reaches the depletion layer. This photon energy is sufficient to generate electron hole pairs in the depletion region. The electric field in the depletion layer pushes away the electrons to the N-type region and holes to the P-type region. Higher concentration of electrons in the N-type region and holes in the P-type region creates a potential difference across the PN junction. As soon as an external load is connected, electrons flow from the N-type region through the load to the P-type region. These electrons recombine with the holes at the P-type region. In this way, a solar cell continuously gives direct current. To explore more, I decided to conduct a small experiment with the solar pan we got. The aim is to plot the VI and power curve of the pan and thus find out its MPP, fill factor and efficiency. The parameters include short circuit current ISC, the open circuit voltage VOC, maximum power point MPP, the ratio of maximum power to the product of ISC and VOC, the fill factor, and finally, the efficiency of the panel. As you can see, the test setup consists of a voltmeter, an ammeter, and a rheostat to vary the load. We have to tabulate the V and the I by varying the rheostat, and then calculate the power at each point. After that, the V, I, and P curves are plotted as shown in the image. MPP, fill factor, and efficiency can be easily deduced from the plot using the equation shown here. From the observations, the efficiency of the solar panel is found to be low, around 15 to 20%. Hence, we require a large number of solar panels to generate a small electric power. Though this makes it less space efficient, we can hope that advanced technologies will find a way out to enhance its efficiency. Any effort will be of great value to the world, since the solar energy is the cleanest energy source, pollution-free and abundant. I hope that this video was informative to you. Please like and subscribe my videos.